Hey guys, welcome to Silicon Valley Girl, my first video in our new house. This is not my studio yet, this is an office that I'm using as a studio because studio is still in progress. But today, we're gonna talk about jobs that you can do from home and make money from home. I recently made this video like 3 or 4 weeks ago. I released a similar video. I got a lot of feedback from you guys, a lot of people thanking me, and something happened in the past few weeks. So basically, I've been ordering a lot of stuff for my house, and I ordered some posters. And posters designed by some artists, they're like beginner artists, they cost me over $100 each. And this is basically just a printed piece of paper. And I was like, oh my God. And I decided that I need to research more jobs that you guys can do from home because, you know, there are so many opportunities out there. Of course, if you're just starting out, you need to work on your portfolio. You need to master your skill. But the earlier you start, the more money you'll be making in 6 months and 9 months and a year. And I really want to provide value with this video. I really want you to write things down, to think about what you can do after you are 9 to 6, what you can do on weekends in order to convert your hobby or something that you're really passionate about in a side business, or maybe it will be your primary activity in a couple months or a couple years. So if you're interested, continue watching this video up to the very end. But before we start, please hit the like button, subscribe to this channel if you're interested in starting a business and starting a side hustle. Job number one that you can do, creating designs for print on demand. The thing is, there are so many platforms out there like Teespring, Merch by Amazon, Redbubble. This is a platform where I, as a creator, for example, I come there and I say, like, hey, I'm looking for a t-shirt that I can sell to my followers and I want something about Silicon Valley on this t-shirt. And I can just either place an order or scroll through the designs that they have. And once I find the design, and these designs are normally created by outside artists. So if you're that designer who's like, oh, I want to create a Silicon Valley image or something, you've created this design, I select your design and I put it on my t-shirt. So Teespring, for example, takes care of everything else. They take care of t-shirts, delivery, etc. Your job is only to submit a design to them. So when I choose your design and put it on my t-shirt, you make money. And this doesn't just apply to t-shirts, it applies to posters, it applies to, you know, different things that you can do, like this one we did a custom for LinguaTrip. But again, your job is to do what you love, create a design, and then the platform is gonna take care of the rest. There are also other platforms, like Etsy is one of the best platforms where you sell things that you make yourself. Again, for example, if you're creating designs for posters, I think that it is crazy, like the markup. I'm just thinking of how much it costs. So one of the posters is shipping from Turkey. And I'm just thinking, like, how much does it cost to print something on? Yeah, it's a huge piece of paper and there's shipping, but still, like, I know that in Russia it will cost me like, I don't know, $10, something like that, $20, but I paid over $100. So the markup is huge. Yes, you need to create a design. Yes, you need to print it. But once you created this design, you just keep producing copies and keep making money. So take a look at those platforms. The next thing that you can do is to start an e-commerce business, which might sound scary at first, but I'm gonna explain you how it works in modern day if you don't have a production site at home, which you probably don't. Quick thing that I did with my company. We found a supplier on Alibaba.com who creates those cases for iPhones. We send them our design, they produce those cases for us, high quality, great, you know, great price. They send everything to us, and then we redistributed cases through our platforms, through other platforms here in the US, like Amazon, etc. This was great, like, because we don't have our own production. And there are certain features on Alibaba.com that you can use as an e-commerce entrepreneur. So first of all, what I really like is that they have rankings for every single category. So every month they would select top 10 products for categories like electronics, fashion, etc. So for example, if you're passionate for fashion, but you don't want to be stuck with a product that doesn't sell, you just go to Alibaba.com and you check what's trending in fashion right now. And you're like, oh my God, maternity clothes are trending or whatever is trending. This is what I need to double down on. The second step you're like, okay, I know which product I want to create. The next step is to find a good supplier. So Alibaba.com features a lot of great suppliers who are verified. And normally the way it works is that they send you a sample. You're like, okay, that's great. And if you like the sample, you just order more items. And this way you can either order something that's ready and just put your brand on it, like name it the way you want, or you can customize it like we did. We took their case, select the color, but send our own design, which isn't really a design, it's just our logo and the name of the company. But this is the way it works with Alibaba.com. And the third thing that I like about Alibaba.com, it is very cost effective. Like, I think this cost us, one piece cost maybe 10 cents, and we were distributing them for, I think it was like $5 or $6. So it's really cost effective, good quality, and you don't have to have your own production site. So check out Alibaba.com for all of those features. The link will be below. The next job that you can do from home is recording audiobooks. The thing is, I'm an author myself. I have two books in Russian. And both of them started out as a printed book, but then I had to wait for a couple of months for my publisher to order an audiobook from someone. And that someone is a freelancer who's sitting at home. You can have like basic equipment. I think this mic is good enough. I think it was around $140 when I got it a couple years ago, but you can find a used version even cheaper. This is a Blue Yeti mic. Yes, you need some equipment on your computer. And yes, you need excellent English if the book is in English, and you need some acting skill. Like, recording a nonfiction book, you don't really need more people. It just can be you. You need some acting in terms of like, and he said, and then something happened, like just acting with your voice, which again, it takes practice, but you can learn that. It's not a skill that takes like 5 years at a university to master. This is something you can do from home. And there is over 1 million books that are published in the US every year. And not every single of them gets an audiobook, because if there is a big publisher, if this book becomes a bestseller, yes, the publisher will order this audio version. But if it's a private author who doesn't have a publisher, and there are so many self-published people right now, like my next book, I'm definitely doing through Amazon, and I would just order an audio version from someone. Take a look at a platform called acx.com. This platform brings together authors and studio professionals, aka people who were like you, who just started recording audiobooks. Another great income idea is writing curricula or lesson plans for teachers. So there are teachers that do a lot of classes and they just don't have time to create their own curricula. And this is when they need some outside help. There is a website called Teachers Pay Teachers, and you can go there if you speak good English, if you can create curricula, and the subjects really vary, and you can create classes for preschoolers, you create classes for school children. So it really depends on what you're passionate about and what you're an expert in. And the thing is, you register there for free, but before you start selling curriculas that you created, you need to upload a free one, but then you can start uploading something that you charge for. And the thing is, it's like with other platforms that I mentioned in my previous videos, like Shutterstock, where you just upload something that you created, and the more people download, the more money you make. So your goal is to create a couple of amazing products and let them generate you some passive income. Prices range from 50 cents to $1 for a 1 to 3 page assignment, and $50 to $100 for a large curricula. The next job that you can do is teaching languages. And the thing is, the demand for languages right now is so high that there are so many platforms that not just hire professional teachers. They hire so-called community teachers. Normally, those community teachers would do like group classes or maybe explain something that people don't understand, like do a QA. But the thing is, you don't have to be a professional teacher. You just have to speak that language really good. And there are platforms like iTalki who are constantly looking for more community teachers. Your main task there would be to hold some speaking classes, do some QAs. Normally, grammar and vocabulary will be taught by some professional teachers, but it's great if you can explain some things. But again, your core job will be just holding a speaking class. Depending on your level, your salary would be from $5 to $15 an hour. But if you decide to go on and become a professional teacher, then you can start making up to $50 an hour. The next idea, if you're watching this video and you come from a low-cost country and you're like, wow, that's all amazing, but I don't want to be a designer, I don't want to produce stuff, I don't want to teach people, but I know a lot of people who want, but they just don't know about these opportunities. Setting up some kind of agency or intermediary between those people in your country who want to do some job but maybe don't speak good English and don't want to communicate with an English-speaking customer and English-speaking customers, and then you charge a price. So I know a couple of companies that do that here in Silicon Valley even. Like they outsource IT development to cheaper countries and they take money from American corporations. The way it works is that American corporations pay those companies monthly and they pay to those contractors back in their country. So they have operations established here in the US and they have operations established in their country. But again, these are bigger companies. You can start as an individual, as a smaller entity. Another thing that you would need to figure out is like how to process payments, because it depends on where you are. But this is a great idea, and again, it's getting traction for IT, for designers, and for other jobs. The next job that you can do from home is data entry. Yes, it's very boring, but this is our reality. A lot of businesses are converting from being offline to being online, and that means like we helped convert a couple of schools from offline to online, and you know, they literally have exercise books full of names of students, full of data that needed to be transferred online, that needed to be manually put in the new system. And this is where data entry specialists are really needed. You can check out platforms like FlexJobs, ClickWorker, and Fiverr. And there are also websites like Exyen Data Services and Data Plus, but new job openings appear on these websites quite rarely. Due to the fact that you do not require some special skills to perform this job, the average salary is like $5 to $10 an hour. And the last but not the least, sell your expert opinion. If you're an expert in something, you can start consulting online. A lot of people are consulting online these days. It can be either admissions consulting or interview prep or whatever. Like, I know so many people who do their 9-to-6 job and also do some consulting that is related to their job because they are experts. Your hourly rate is totally up to you. I know people who make like $50,000 a month just consulting. This is not something that is scalable because this is your time. And I've done some consulting. I've done some US admissions consulting. I got bored in like 3 years because I started a YouTube channel, which is another great idea, but still, it generated some valuable income for me for a couple of years. And there are a couple of platforms that would help you automate everything like scheduling, pricing, etc. For example, Vix.com is where you can create a website. And if you become their member, you can start charging people and start scheduling consultations. There is clarity.fm/expert. And there is also coach.me/apply. You can register on those platforms as a coach and start selling your sessions. Yes, you need to figure out marketing, price, etc. But as with any job, anything that you do, you need to start first. You know, don't worry about the problems before you start, because the mistake that a lot of people make, they're like, oh my God, but what if this? What if that? What if this happens? Like, don't think about it. Things are gonna happen and you're gonna figure them out. Like being in business for, what is it? 9 years. Oh, 10 years this year. Oh my God. Like things happen every single day. You just need to love what you do and you'll be able to cope with those problems. Thank you guys so much for watching this video up to the very end. Thank you Alibaba.com for sponsoring this video. Check out their link below and subscribe to this channel if you haven't done that at the beginning of this video. Thank you guys so much. I'll see you very soon in my next vlogs. Bye bye.